problem. Here is my basic problem.
What? I lied to them.
This gentleman has been Muslim for 6 years.
Don't read them, my friend. Don't read.
And because Islam is logical and rational,
you are not.
There is no answer. There is no basic answer to my question on the Tawhid.
Yeah, it's very easy.
There is no proper answer to the black stone.
Not knowledgeable about Islam and argue with
them. Well
done.
Muslims today disagree. You don't need to be Einstein. Don't play victim game.
I came here to listen to your point against Islam.
Sir.
Not to argue with you. This is the first
thing. Okay, now you heard
and
my objection.
Now you're saying, oh, look at this convert. He doesn't know what he's talking about.
I'm not saying that.
What I'm saying is,
you've been Muslim for 6 years.
She was just saying that in the camera.
You've been Muslim for six years. You were not even able to
from the first
answer basic Islam 101. 101 on Tawhid. There is no basic answer to the black stone. There is no even basic answer to what Muhammad did to Aisha. But what we are getting is that was for that time. Muhammad is for that time, not for 21st century. Surah 65 verse 4. Surah 65 verse 4.
In the Bible.
Doesn't make sense to the Muslims. Muslims wouldn't practice it. But it is still in the Quran. Give up Islam as now you can. Give it up now you can before Islam takes over speaker's corner.
That's why I'm not interested in Christianity. Because it doesn't make any sense.
What is this?
You know what is this?
Stabilizer for
iPhone. They are not practicing.
I'm not recording.
No. So you put the phone in here too.
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm not recording.
No. I don't care. Comrades are recording in here. I must express I am very much disappointed that. Actually, let me ask you. What is
you want to argue? We'll continue arguing with you for your content. Yeah, to put the title that converted Muslim doesn't know.
You don't know the Tawhid.
Because this is my first time here, and you're using this opportunity.
You caught me like that.
Answer.
I am here every week.
Where is the common sense? You are a big Christian. Don't make any sense to me at all.
I know, because I read the Islamic tradition, I read the Quran, and they don't make sense. I can't do much about it.
Let me ask you a question. You want to continue?
You need to have the knowledge. Okay. Would you beat your wife?
No, of course not.
You wouldn't.
Oh, now you're going to tell me that this is according to Islam. I need to beat my wife if she cheated on me, right? That's what you're going to say.
If she cheated on you, is that the reason?
Yeah, you will tell me right now.
No, is that the reason?
No.
So, you wouldn't beat your wife?
No.
If Allah tells you to
beat... Not in any circumstances.
Not in any circumstances.
No.
Go to Surah 34. Can you read Surah 4 verse 34 for me?
I don't have...
Good that we've got here walking Quran.
434.
No, but I see what she's doing. I see what she's doing. Yeah, this is my first time here. I am here every week. She caught someone who has a lack of knowledge about Islam. Oh, he's the converted. Then she's going to put the title to put me down. And this is a trick.
Let me make something very clear. Brother, just a moment. Let me make something very clear. I am here every Sunday. Okay?
Yeah, this is my first time.
I have not asked you. Give me the isnad for that Quran. Okay? I have not asked you. Give me the theology behind Aruf. Okay? Because you already told me you are not knowledgeable enough. Therefore, the questions I ask you is, what would you do? What do you think about it?
Okay?
Therefore, don't play that victim game. It doesn't work with me. Even now.
Now you're asking this type of questions.
Did I not ask you would you kiss the black stone?
No, you did. You did.
Yeah, so those my questions were too personal. I didn't ask you, please give me the theology why there is black stone in this world. I didn't tell you, how can heavenly being end up in this broken world and change and transform? I didn't ask you that question because that is like probably more homework, okay? So don't kind of play that victim game.
Not playing.
So
I'm not playing. Yes.
You told me that you wouldn't beat your wife in any under.
I would.
So can you? You wouldn't beat your wife under any circumcision.
Let him read that, please. Explain to me Surah 4, verse 34.
This is the verse I want to
know. Sure, that this is the correct translation.
But it's translated
how can I be
Arabic
sure?
Is here.
It's a Muslim website. It's okay, a Muslim application.
I see. Yeah,
it's Muslim
right.
application. Okay. No. I've got this from Muslim application. Okay.
He can. Arabic. Anyone reads Arabic?
So you can't believe what she's reading.
No, I just want to clarify. I'm not saying anything.
It's not. He doesn't. It's not. He doesn't believe. He doesn't trust the translation.
There is no if. Okay. I just want to clarify.
Do you read Arabic?
We can read different translation if you like.
No. Okay. I just want someone to
read Arabic.
To translate me in Arabic.
Because I know that is Arabic speaker, but he doesn't want to read it. It's fine. So
this is translated by Muslims.
It has been translated by devoted Muslims.
How can I be sure?
Go to
the translation.
Just pick up the one you pick. Like, which one do you recite? Which one do you study in your time?
Al-Fatiha.
Which translation?
Al-Fatiha is just one surah.
Al-Fatiha is only first surah of the Quran.
So
which translation do you read for your personal study?
Are you talking about the language or what?
Which translation of the Quran you read in your personal time?
What do you mean?
For example, I'm Christian, every day I read the Bible, and like this month, for example, I'm reading NIV translation, okay?
Yeah.
So. I am Muslim. I'm Christian. Currently, I'm using actively Yusuf Ali translation as well as Muhsin Khan translation.
Yeah.
So when you read the Quran, you are not Arabic speaker, and your Arabic is like beginners. So which translation of the Quran do you read? Which English translation? Muhsin Khan, Sahih International, Yusuf Ali. There are over 100 translations. Which one do you read?
Oh, I cannot answer to you. I don't know. I have the Quran in English.
What does the cover look like? That's not very happy. Turn to Yusuf Ali, like in here, I've got Yusuf Ali translation.
Sahih International, Pictol, Muhsin Khan.
He can go all of that. If you are going to come back next week, okay? We pick one, let's say it goes with Sahih International, okay?
Yeah.
That is like well known in Muslim circle. Okay. Or go with the Yusuf Ali, okay? And then go home, check it out, come back next week. If we are misrepresenting, I am here every week to be debunked, okay? And Kamra is here, come and tell me we were lying, because all he did was just reading to you, translated by devoted Muslims, okay? So, brother, can we read that again and then ask him to explain?
Exactly, that's why I came here. I wanted to have arguments against Islam, so then I can study, ask, double check.
Do you live in London?
Of course.
Then you should come back next week. You have got no excuse.
London is, of course.
Okay? Can we read it again?
I didn't come here to argue with someone because I'm not...
That's absolutely fine, sir. We have discussions, debates. That's the nature of speakers' corner. So, let's turn 434.
Men are in charge of women by right of what Allah has given one over the other.
I'm going to take a picture of this.
Yeah, sure thing.
Do you have Quran on your phone? You don't have Quran on your phone?
I have the app.
Christian said, go to the app on your phone.
I think that's the same. It's the Muslim Pro. Is this the Muslim Pro?
No, this is... I don't know what the name of this one is.
He's got the Muslim Pro.
I don't know which one.
This one is called like Quran Pro. Majid.
Okay.
Quran
okay,
Majid.
Okay.
Go to your Muslim Pro one. Yep. Surah 434. Find the Surah 4 verse 34. No. You go back. Surah 4. Move down. Oh, you don't have the translation.
I don't have the translation here. I'm using it for prayers, yeah. I'm using the English one that I have at home.
So in here, what is your quick response to this one? And then you can do homework and then come back next week.
I took a picture of this.
Before you go home, you said you wouldn't beat your wife, okay?
This one
says strike your wife. First, it says like you advise them, forsake them in bed and strike them. So if Allah says,
where's the balance?
What is strike
them,
means?
Yeah,
strike them.
Okay. Yes.
Yeah. So do you have a problem with that verse?
Say it.
Do you have a problem with the verse?
With this verse? I need to double check. I don't want to tell you something right now.
So this verse...
When I see this the first time.
So, yeah? What do you mean? You never seen this verse before?
This particular verse, I haven't seen before.
But you've been Muslim for 6 years. You've got to study.
I didn't study every day. I didn't study every day.
It is.
I
shouldn't be the one who gives you.
I had years.
But he doesn't know Arabic.
I had my years of ignorance.
Just a moment. I'm Christian, okay?
Yeah.
Doesn't matter you are Muslim, you are Christian. Whatever religion you follow, it is very important that we take time and invest it.
Sure, okay? Of course, without apps, yeah.
And if you are coming to Speaker's Corner, and if you are going to come back again, just beware. People at Speaker's Corner, you've got Muslim missionaries, you've got Christian missionaries, and we are here in the intention of arguing and debating.
I know, yeah.
So if you have not studied it, it will be put in very bad place, okay? And it wouldn't look very good for you.
But it wasn't my intention to come here and argue with someone.
But this is Speaker's Corner.
I know, but
and
lots
I am,
of people listening.
How long have you been looking into Islam? So you've been Muslim for 6 years.
6 years and properly looking at them. Two and a half years,
and you never come across with the verse, Allah has pit your wife. I find that's very sad, it's very, very sad. But come back, please come back next week, and then I will butcher you next week from the topics we discussed today, okay? You have got like whole week to prepare your answers. And then after that, we can have discussions. You can ask me the questions you want.
Okay.
I'm here every Sunday, and I don't come here with running shoes.
Okay, fair enough.
Okay?
Yeah,
but this gentleman speaks Arabic, apparently. Do you want to get the clarification of the verse from him?
Him.
He doesn't want to be recorded. Anyway, so I'll see you next week. Look at the Tahweed, look at the Blackstone, look at the child marriage, and then the last one is the wife beating. Okay?
Yeah.
And hopefully I'll see you next week.
All right. Okay, fair enough.